Welcome to a quick little tree identification walk. We don't have an extraordinary diversity of trees in the Willamette Valley, or really throughout much of Oregon for that matter, but we do have some really common and iconic species that you can see kind of up and down the Willamette Valley, and we'll take a look at some of those today. Right here next to me is the Oregon white oak. We have two oak species in the Willamette Valley. We also have the California black oak, and that really just kind of reaches into the lower stretches of the Willamette Valley. It's a little more common in the South Eugene foothills. We actually only have a single black oak specimen on the mountain on the entire 2,200 acres that we know of. So not too common here. All of our oaks, except that one at the Arboretum, are Oregon white oaks. And this is kind of the characteristic leaf shape for Oregon white oaks. They're just kind of loosely lobed. They might have a few sharper points, but the California black oak tends to kind of terminate in some really sharp points at the end of the leaf lobes. These tend to be a lot more rounded. That's really kind of the easiest way to tell them apart. Now you get a lot of variation in some of the Oregon white oak leaves. Some look quite a bit more pointed, but if you kind of average them out overall from a tree, you're going to see a lot more of that rounding. They also produce a little bit of a different acorn. The Oregon white oak has a pretty kind of round, chubby acorn, kind of the classic acorn look. The California black oak is similar, but a little bit more elongated. So another thing that you see really commonly on the oaks, and this includes the black oak as well, is these little leaf galls. So these are made by a tiny wasp. We're talking about, you know, 2 millimeters, that lays an egg on the mid vein usually of the leaf, and that induces the leaf to create this growth, which is the gall. And so the wasp larvae, just a single one per gall, develops inside. And this serves as both food and housing for that larvae while it develops. So pretty spectacular. We have a number of different wasps that create these little galls on the oaks, and each gall looks differently. So you can actually identify the wasp species just based on their gall alone. But this is a great clue for identifying the trees. And this is something that we use frequently when teaching younger kids about how to identify trees out here. Because they love these galls. And if you find a leaf with a gall on it underneath the tree, pretty good chance it's gonna be an oak. So it's not always quite so easy, but sometimes you can use clues to identify dead trees too. So this is an Oregon white oak that's been laying dead on the ground here for over a decade now. And it's a pretty fantastic specimen and something that people really enjoy coming to check out. And part of the reason for that is it's covered in these mushrooms, and these are mushrooms that only grow on oaks. So it's a great clue for identifying the dead tree. This is the oak maze gill, and it's called that because of the gills on the underside of the fungus, and they look a lot like a maze. And the Latin name is actually Daedalia quercina, and the Daedalia refers to the Greek myth of Daedalus, who was trapped in the labyrinth.